welcome back to my kitchen. This is one of my favorite times of the year because I get to make lots of yummy foods that I can take to work, I can feed all the family, share with my neighbors. So today, we're gonna make the copycat version of Toscana soup. And it's super yummy, super easy to make. I'm so excited you guys are here with me today. But we need to register on rockinourdisabilities.com. Either through the email, through the website, other avenues of social media. We also need to make sure we wash our hands really good and all of our vegetables that we're gonna be using today. But let's dive into what ingredients we need. So, we're gonna need a big pot. Or if you're using a cooking pot that the cast iron ones, or if you wanna use, some of us have like the Instapot. I don't have an Instapot, I'm just gonna use my regular pot, but you can also use a crock pot too if you'd like. I'm gonna set that aside. You're going to need at least 4 potatoes. I'm gonna add a little more, but we wanna make sure that we scrub and wash the skin really good. You don't have to peel it if you don't want to, but that is an option. We're gonna need some garlic, at least 2 cloves. We're gonna need some Italian sausage. I'm gonna be using hot Italian, but you're welcome to use regular or mild. We're gonna need some salt and pepper. We're gonna need at least 8 slices of bacon, some heavy cream, some flour. You can also use cornstarch if you don't have flour. We're gonna need some yellow onion, some chicken broth, as well as kale. Yeah. And then just a little bit of olive oil or cooking oil or whatever oil you use so we can get our ingredients warmed up and ready to go. So let's go wash our hands right now. And then I'm gonna wash all of my vegetables really good and get them all ready. As well as I'm gonna put my sausage and my bacon on a baking sheet and stick it in the oven to warm them up. Get it kind of cooked all the way through. If you wanna do that in a pan, you're more than welcome to do that too. I'm just gonna be kind of doing a lot, so I wanna stick it in the oven, not have to worry about it while I'm cooking other things, okay? So let's go get started. Okay, so right now I'm gonna get my bacon and my sausage ready. You're welcome to do this on the stovetop if you wanna do it like in a frying pan or something like that. If you have a toaster oven, you're welcome to do it in that too. But what I'm gonna do so I can work on all the other stuff as well and then let it cool down a little bit before I cut it is I'm going to put my bacon and my sausage in the oven and warm it for about like 15 minutes or so. I'm gonna turn my oven on to 350 and put my bacon on. Now we're gonna cut all this up later, but you want it to kind of be cooked most of the way through. It will cook more when it's in the soup. Okay, get my sausage ready. Now, if you're gonna be doing sausage on the in the oven, or if you have a toaster oven, and it's in sausage form, you wanna poke some holes in it so that all the juice, the fat and stuff can kind of come out and it won't explode. Like sometimes if you like microwave a hot dog and then you cook it just a little bit too long, it explodes. If you've ever cooked it on the grill, not always the pleasantest thing in the world. Not like that makes a drastic difference because we're just gonna cut these up, but I don't wanna clean up a big mess later. Okay. Throw this away. All right, now I'm gonna stick it in the oven for about 25 minutes. So I'm gonna set 1 timer on my phone and 1 on my kitchen because I'm gonna need it for other things. Okay, here we go. Let's get everything else ready. So now I'm gonna wash my potatoes and my kale really good, and I'm gonna mince up my garlic and my onion, okay? Now when washing potatoes, I always use this like rough side of a new sponge. So it, you know, you're not like spreading germs or anything like that. But you wanna make sure you wash them in warm water and you scrub them pretty good so you get all the little like nooks and crannies, because that's where dirt really likes to hide, and we don't want to transfer that in our soup. So let's get washing. Now we want to chop up a medium onion and at least 2 cloves of garlic. If you're like me and want to use more garlic, you're more than welcome to. But I'm going to show you how to chop this all up and get it ready to cook, okay? You always take the top off. And the bottom. Okay, so this next part is a little bit of a challenge to kind of show you. So I'm trying to tilt the camera where you can kind of see, but what we're going to do is we're gonna get our onions sauteed to where they're translucent. Translucent means that they're like see-through, like you can't really see them anymore. So I'm gonna add a little bit of oil and heat up my pan that I'm gonna cook everything in. And then I'm gonna put the onions in and saute them. So I have to stir them around and make sure that they don't burn because I want them to be see-through, like they're clear. Okay, so I'm just gonna add just a little bit of oil. You don't need to measure it out, just enough to kind of coat the bottom a little bit. Because what you're gonna do is the oil's gonna burn off. So I'm gonna turn my pan on. Turn my stove on. All right. Now I'm just adding the onions first. Ooh. Got a little messy. That's okay. Okay. Now I'm going to stir them around so that they don't boil over. Burn. You don't want burnt onions. Those are not fun. So you can kind of see them in there. So you want to keep them moving until they become see-through. That's called translucent. Okay, so most of my onions are now kind of see-through. Remember the word translucent, kind of see-through. Some of the smaller pieces are a little crispy, and that's okay because that adds really yummy flavor. So what I'm gonna do now is add my garlic, and that needs to cook for about a minute before we start adding in other ingredients. So I have my stopwatch ready. I'm gonna cook it for a minute. You wanna stir it around. And then we're gonna start adding in our other ingredients. Ooh, it smells so yummy. And my bacon and sausage is almost ready to take out. And that smells so yummy. My house smells so good. I hope your kitchen smells so good too. Check my stopwatch, 30 seconds in. Okay, I'm gonna turn my fire off to get out all the rest of the ingredients I need. I need to get out my chicken stock. Keep checking my watch, 45 seconds. Make sure it's nice, stir it around. Good, and a minute, all right. Turn my fire off, and now I'm gonna get out the rest of my ingredients, okay? I'll see you guys in a second. So I just finished sauteing my onions and my garlic, and I'm setting that aside for a second so I can work on cutting out my potatoes. And you wanna cut them where they're kind of small enough where you can eat them, but big enough where they can get mashed up a little bit. So you wanna make sure when you look at it that it has no icky gross spots. I'm going to cut it long ways first and check it, make sure there's no icky spots. Then I'm going to cut that in half again. And then I'm going to start slicing it kind of thin. There we go. Now, I always like to rinse them one more time after this. So I'm gonna put them back in my strainer to rinse them. And then I'm gonna put them in my pot to cook them. See, so you want them to be about this size. Look, it looks like a little slice of pizza. Okay, so they're not too thin, but they're not super thick. So I would say that's like maybe a centimeter or so wide. All right, so I'm gonna finish cutting all of my potatoes up. I'm gonna rinse them off one more time And then I'm gonna throw it in there. You don't have to. I just prefer it only because I don't want my soup super starchy. So that's just a personal preference of mine. I'm kind of weird like that. So then you can just stick these right into your pot, or you can rinse them off one more time. Okay, now that I have cut up all my potatoes and I just rinsed them off again, now I need to add my chicken stock and my potatoes and then let that cook for 15 minutes on medium heat. So I'm gonna turn my heat back on and I'm going to put in my ingredients. I'm gonna turn. Maybe. There we go. Turn my heat. Medium. Now I'm gonna put my potatoes in. Lots of potatoes. Ah! I splashed myself. There we go. All right. Now it calls for 32 ounces, which is equivalent to 4 cups if you have a bigger container. I just got the one, let's see if I can kind of show you, that says 32 ounces. But if you use a different brand or different type or whatever, that equivalents to 4 cups. So I'm just gonna pour the whole thing in. And that should cover most of your potatoes. If you need to add just a little bit more, usually 2 cups of water will also kind of work with you, but you wanna make sure that your potatoes are covered. Gonna give it a quick stir and then I'm gonna let this cook for 15 minutes. 15 minutes. All right. Okay, see you guys in 15 minutes. When we are cutting up our kale, we wanna take it away from the spine, which is like the stem. So I'm gonna pick some off, and then some of the bigger pieces, I'm just gonna kind of loosely chop so it's not such a big piece when you try to go and eat it. But you wanna make sure that you're taking it away from the spine. It's called the spine, the big piece. So when I cut it, see some of these bigger pieces? I'm just gonna kind of put them together. And do just a rough chop. You always want to cut away from you. So now these are more bite-sized pieces. Okay? So now I need to chop up my bacon and my sausage. So what I do is I put a paper towel down first. And it's cool enough to touch. And I'm just going to kind of get some of that excess oil, because I don't really want to put that on my body. Okay, now set that right there. So now I need to cut up my sausage and my bacon. So you just kind of want to chop it up, just a nice rough chop. See, so it doesn't have to be perfect. Just want to cut it up so it's now bite-sized pieces, and that's, same thing goes with your bacon. You can towel it off too a little later after you're done chopping it all up so you don't have all this excess oil or fat. And then we're gonna throw it in the pot once 15 minutes are up. Of course, you know you have to taste test. Yum. Okay, friends, as you can see, my pot is getting full. It's starting to bubble. It's smelling really, really, really good. Okay, I might have to transfer this to a bigger pot. So now I'm gonna add my heavy cream, and you want a cup of that, or if you know the equivalent, that's a half pint. Half pint equals 1 cup. So I'm gonna pour that in there. Maybe, if I can open it. Ooh.
Well, I'm not so good at opening these. Like the little ones we had in elementary school. All right. I'm gonna pour that in there. Oh, it smells good. Stir that around. Now, if you want, you can add salt and pepper to taste. I'm just gonna add pepper because we have some dietary restrictions in our household. Okay, get that stirred around. Ooh. Also gonna add 2 tablespoons of flour. 2 tablespoons of flour. This will help thicken it up a little bit. Perfect. Set that aside. Okay, I'm gonna get that nice and stirred in so it's not lumpy. No one likes lumpy soup or lumpy gravy. Okay. Perfect. Then I'm gonna add in some sausage and bacon. Let it kind of towel off. And I'm also gonna add in my kale. Now you want everything to kind of cook thoroughly through, which will take about 10 minutes, depending on how much potatoes you put in and how much sausage and stuff you put in, but it'll take about 10 minutes. And you wanna leave it uncovered, so open like this, and the kale will turn a little bit of a brighter green. And that's when you know it's like really done. So we're gonna let that cook all the way through. I'll see you guys then. Hi guys, I'm so excited we made this recipe together. I have my brother here because, you know, of course I gotta feed him, right? Yeah, and he loves this soup. It's one of his favorites. It's also at Olive Garden if you guys like to try it. But this is kind of the copycat version of it. So Mikey, you ready to try it? I made him a big bowl. Ready? Okay, so we just poured our bowls. It was about 20 minutes or so. Yeah. Okay, ready? Let's see how it tastes. Oh yeah, so good. Can you taste the sausage? Yeah, I got the hot one. Yeah. So I hope you guys enjoy your recipe. I hope you guys have a great time making this. And it gets you nice and warm and fuzzy because it's getting super cold at night. So I'll see you guys again soon. And I'm so glad you came with us into my kitchen. And I hope you guys have a great time. I'll see you again for the next recipe. And we'll see you soon. Ready? Mm-hmm. Bye.